All right, so on this mini bike, what we're gonna be doing is we have a 75 tooth sprocket, a stock one that's on it right now. And right now, roughly on the stock motor, stock governor, we're topping out at 40 miles an hour. So we're gonna go down in teeth. We're gonna try a 65 tooth sprocket and see what top speed we get out of it. And then we also have a 60 tooth sprocket that we can go down to. But first we'll go with the 65 and we'll see how fast we can go. All right, so first, I'm gonna take off the rear axle. Get that spacer out of there. Get off that side in the axle. And more chain. So we're gonna take off these right here to get rid of this axle real quick. So let me get this tool real quick. All right, so I'm taking these off. It's a 5mm. Once you break them loose, then you can use a gun to remove them all the way. Just don't use an impact, because an impact will break them. So there's our 75 tooth sprocket, which is literally just for acceleration, which we want more top speed. Here's the sprocket we're gonna put on, which is a, hold on, it's a little tight. Let me clean this up and we'll get back. All right, so we actually have to go to the 60 tooth sprocket, so we'll forget about the 65 for now. 65 is a steel sprocket, but it does not line up. I won't tell you guys where I bought this from, but yeah, this one don't line up for us. I gotta make the holes bigger. So we're gonna be going with the 62 sprocket aluminum, and we got this one from OMB Warehouse, Grey Goat Garage. So this is the one we're gonna be using. This one fits in it. It does fit snug around the rim, which, you know, around the little outside diameter right here, it is pretty snug, so you gotta tap it in a little bit, but all the bolt holes line up, so that'll work for us. And then we'll figure out something with this 65, see what we do with that one. All right, so we're gonna be putting these bolts back on. Use Loctite all the time. Anytime you use anything, always Loctite everything. You know, these little bolts do tend to want to come out, or they do break. It's just a habit of using Loctite on everything. So let's get this one in there as well. And always run down the bolts by hand. It makes it so much easier, just to make sure you don't strip anything. Okay. Yeah, so what do you guys think? Write down in the comments what you guys think, how fast we're gonna go. So we're dropping 15 teeth, which is a pretty big change. It should be able to go pretty quick now. So let's see, let's get this tightened down. I'm just gonna run them down with this, not gonna tighten them. Okay, we got them all tightened down. Now let's get it back on the bike and we'll see how much of our chain we gotta cut. So let's get this back in here. Okay, let's get this axle
axle in first. Whoops. Okay. All right, so let's put this right here. Let's get our spacer back in.
This is also going to help us with those wheelies, so it won't wheelie the whole time, give us some more drivability out of the bike. Okay, so let's tighten this down real quick, this axle. Oops. Okay, now let's find our link. Let's see. Oh, it's right here. Let me pop our link off real quick. All right, so let's pop that little link off, just like that. Oops. Without losing the parts. Okay, let's take off this one. So we're actually gonna be cutting a good amount of this chain. So, need to cut there. All right, I'll get back to you guys right now after I cut this chain. Okay, so we got the chain cut. We cut off a couple links. So now let's get our thing back in there, our link. That piece. Take off these gloves because they ripped. And then let's get this little lock back on. Okay. All right, so we got the 60 tooth sprocket on. We got our chain cut, so we should be okay. It's a little loose, but it'll be all right. We got rid of our 75, so here's the big 75er, which obviously it's way too big already. That's more for acceleration for the smaller motors they come with. So we got it from OMB Warehouse. We're gonna be putting the sticker on our bike. Put it right here. So thanks to OMB Warehouse for having the right parts for us. And let's get some top speed runs on it and let's see how fast we can.
Alright you guys, we got the 60 tooth sprocket on here. I got the little GPS in my pocket. Let's see if we could beat our top speed of 39. Okay, let's see if it made a difference. Well, definitely, I'll tell you what, it's definitely be cruisable now. So I'm pretty sure we did get a higher top speed. Because you can actually get on it now and cruise it. Before it would really top out really quick on the 75 tooth sprocket. All right, you guys, so the sprocket did make a difference. So the good thing is that it did gain 4 miles an hour on the stock motor, so that's an improvement, which is good, because the motor still stock internally is still governed, so right away it tops out. Now it's able to actually cruise, so that's a good thing. We can actually cruise it now, so that's not bad. We gained 4 miles an hour. I know we can gain way more than 4 miles an hour once we, you know, remove the governor and stuff like that. So stay tuned for more videos, and thank you guys for watching as always. You know, stay tuned for more mini bike content and other motorcycles, and I appreciate you guys watching and liking the videos. And all right, see you guys in the next one.